नाले में,
हवा में, टॉयलेट में,
ग्रीन्स, सीवर,
सीवर से आगे कहाँ जाता है? सीवर से आगे
क्या कहाँ हमें क्या
मेन हॉल जो होता है,
इट गोज इनटू द ड्रेन एंड देन इट गेट्स ट्रीटेड एट सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट,
गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड एंड अगेन इट इज यूज्ड बैक आल्सो।
अरे यार प्यूरिफाई होगा, पागल है,
लेट्रिन, टॉयलेट में, नाले में, नदी में, नदी से समुद्र में, अरे वो जाएगा तो जमीन के अंदर, हमारा जल दूषित होगा, वही हम पियेंगे।
I think it goes back to the Yamuna.
I don't know regarding sanitary thing. I mean,
उसको कोई एसिड जो होता है गैस, या तो उसको गैस बनाकर बॉल जलाया, लाइट जलाया जाता है, गैस लाइट होता है।
आप चटनी का गैस बनाते हैं?
बनाते नहीं है, बनता है,
नहीं पता।
How do we figure out where our shit goes? To solve this problem, we use a shit flow diagram, also known as the excreta flow diagram.
The shit flow diagram, or SFD, is a powerful mapping tool for city planners, engineers, and consultants. It instantly communicates where the excreta of a city goes after it leaves its source. A single graphic at a glance tells how the excreta travels from the points of generation to the sites of disposal.
I think it has to do with, as I said earlier, recognizing where the problem is. If the problem is that not people have enough latrines, then maybe, an approach on building latrines solved the problem. But that, as we've seen, it tends not to be the case. The problem is after the toilet. What happens to the sludge? Is it contained? Is it emptied? Do the emptiers take it to the treatment plant? And the shit flow allows you to see, okay, what parts of this chain are dysfunctional, and therefore it helps with designing interventions aimed at those particular breakdowns in the fecal sludge management chain.
The top row of the graphic is the sanitation service chain. Containment has three broad categories: off-site sanitation, on-site sanitation, and open defecation. Each of the categories are represented by boxes of different width. The width of each box represents the percentage of population dependent on that particular category. This sounds simple, right? The SFD graphic is read from left to right. The width of each arrow represents the percentage of population dependent on that particular system. The wastewater arrow originates from the off-site sanitation system, while the arrows representing fecal sludge and supernatant originate from the on-site sanitation system. The arrows are marked either in red or green depending on how the excreta is managed at each stage of the sanitation chain. Green means safe, whereas red means unsafe. If pathogen transmission to general public is limited by the system, it is considered as a contained system, and hence is shown as green in color. Otherwise, red is used. The green arrows tend to go towards the right, whereas the red arrows generally drop down.
Groundwater pollution is an important factor which determines whether a system is contained or not. Whether a particular system is polluting the groundwater is a site-specific question. For example, in Bikaner, an unlined pit would be considered a contained system, as the groundwater table is very low. To determine the risk of groundwater pollution, there is a separate tab available on the graphic generator where, by answering the questions like groundwater table, type of soil, extent of extraction of water, one would get to know whether the risk is significant or not.
Let's take the SFD of Cuttack as an example. Here, one can see that the wastewater generated by 19% of its population is contained, as they are connected to a sewerage network, and hence that arrow is marked as green. The arrow in red, on the other hand, is for the 3% of population's wastewater which is not contained, as it flows into the open drains. Similarly, both the arrows of supernatant and fecal sludge are red, as septic tanks connected to open drain is considered as a not contained system. There is also a red arrow for the 11% of the population that defecate in the open, which is also considered as not contained. The green arrows under the emptying and transportation segments indicate that the wastewater from 7% of population is safely transported and delivered to the treatment plants. But the wastewater from the 14% of population is not treated and hence drops down as a red arrow. The arrows for supernatant and fecal sludge also follow a similar pattern. If the emptied fecal sludge and supernatant is delivered to the treatment plants, the arrow turns green, otherwise it drops down as red. So in total, the excreta of 31% of population is safely managed, while the excreta of 69% of population is not.
The shit flow diagram has two components. One is the graphic and the other is the report. The graphic should be read with the report because the report has the quality of the service being delivered across the sanitation chain. If you want to understand the excreta management of the city, the graphic should be read with the report. The report also gives us the source of data, the stakeholders involved, and also the assumptions made to make the graphic.
So how do we make this shit flow diagram? The process of developing an SFD starts by getting a broad understanding of the city and assessing the sanitation scenario in that location. This is done through the collection of required data on population and the sanitation systems in the city from secondary data sources. The secondary data include literature review of published, unpublished, and government documents pertaining to sanitation, such as the census reports, detailed project reports, city sanitation plans, master plans, and many more. So what should be the next step? To identify the stakeholders from whom the required data can be collected, a well-defined strategy should be developed to engage with the identified stakeholders. This strategy may include field observations of the prevalent systems and services, feedback from informants, measurement of the efficiency of treatment systems, and focus group discussions with the stakeholders involved. This quantitative data is then fed into the SFD graphic generator. The SFD graphic generator produces an SFD graphic which depicts the management of excreta at each of the four stages of the service delivery chain.
I think this has helped a lot when we were trained on this particular tool by Center for Science and Environment. We learned that how only by inputting data this shit flow diagram can be generated. So this particular infographic has been very effective and I think this should continue.
So how to use an SFD graphic generator? Now let us go through the official website www.sfd.susanna.org to understand how to generate an SFD using the SFD tool. Click on the toolbox option and select SFD graphic generator. Now click on Start New SFD Graphic. Let us go one step at a time. Step 1. Enter the general information about the city, such as the name of the city, state and country. Put in the date on which the graphic is prepared. Then fill in the population, the type of SFD level and the name of the person who prepared the SFD. Now select all possible sanitation systems present in the city. Mark it in the selection grid given below. To understand the parameters and details about the selection grid, click on the alphabet I in the right corner. Clicking on I opens up the instructions on how to use the selection grid. To answer the questions pertaining to groundwater pollution, one needs to click on the button called Risk of Groundwater Pollution. The left column of the selection grid describes all types of containment systems. The consecutive columns describe what these containment systems are connected to. Let us assume in a city X, three types of containment systems are present. A toilet with no on-site containment, which is connected to a centralized combined sewer, a septic tank, which is connected to an open drain, and a lined pit with semi-permeable walls, with an open bottom and no outlet. To create an SFD matrix, enter the proportion of fecal sludge one can find inside each type of containment system. For further explanation on this, click on I present on the rightmost corner. Next, click on Create SFD Matrix. An SFD matrix appears. The leftmost column consists of the selected containment systems. As one can notice, each containment system is labeled by a unique variable, one should refer to the SFD glossary to understand the systems through the variables in depth. The next column indicates the proportion of population who use each of the containment systems. The consecutive columns indicate questions on the proportion of wastewater, fecal sludge, and supernatant along the service delivery chain. Step 3. Now, select Draw SFD Graphic. The SFD graphic of City X shows that the excreta of 52% of population is safely managed and the remainder is unsafely managed. The SFD graphic and the data fed into making the SFD can be further downloaded and saved by clicking on Download Data and by selecting the required file.
Yeah, actually it is like interesting tool, but data intensive also. We didn't have so much of data about the containments because you, as you know, the census does not have so much detailed information on containment. It just says a septic tank and a pit latrine and open defecation, that's it. So to have intensive data, we had done a baseline study, so that was a sample based. So from that we could pull out some different types of containments and then we could filter them out and match to what criteria SFD tool demands.
A city should make a shit flow diagram because it's a much more accurate representation of the problem that untreated fecal sludge does for the environment, for the health. If you look at a place like Dhaka, Bangladesh, if they are using the traditional measure of access sanitation, more than 98% of the people have that access. But if you look at where that the sludge goes, it also turns out that more than 90% is not treated. That's why, you know, a representation like the shit flow diagram is more accurate.
When we started working on the SFD, it was primarily used as an assessment tool for excreta flows. With time, we realized its potential as an effective advocacy and monitoring tool as well. All in all, CSE has produced SFDs for 27 cities in India and has extensively used them for advocacy purpose. So, if your city does not have an SFD yet, go ahead and start producing one to create awareness on excreta management and to determine the gaps present in the service delivery chain.